might not hide things, but also she's always been like this, like very not outspoken. So things that I do was that, like, I used to, when we first got married and, you know, through the years, it seemed like everything was fine. Like, not necessarily that I made the decisions, but I will ask her, and she was always on board with it. So now she says that she's not. Like, I don't understand it. Where is this coming from?
Yeah, I think it's just, I mean, we're okay through the years. I think because of everything that happened with maybe having cancer and going through treatments, now I just see things differently.
So would you say that you want more?
I just don't want to be, I feel like I'm a burden.
Okay.
Because, I mean, I hear all these negative things about, oh, you do this, you don't even do that. Or, and at times I feel like, yeah, I don't have a job. But I'm willing, now that I'm getting all my energy back, trying to see if I can go back to working.
Yeah.
And I don't know if that's something that he, I know it might help the situation, but I don't know if it'll help with the whole comment thing.
So Miguel, when you heard Carol just say that she feels like a burden, what is your response to that?
That really kind of hurts me a little bit, because I don't see her as a burden. You know, she's been my wife for 15 years, and I never seen her that like as a burden, and I know that what she's going through, it's hard. Another thing that I've seen to change is that I know that she's kind of gotten out with her friends more.
Mm-hmm.
Before she kind of secluded herself, and now she's going out more. And I mean, I don't say anything. I want her, because I understand now this life changes that she's gone through.
Yeah.
So I allow her, but now I'm questioning what if her friends are kind of putting things in her head.
It
really surprises me.
I don't think,
because using
so.
Those words, burden, I'm rude, or those comments, those were not before, they were not, or maybe her coming to you. It's like, are you giving her ideas, or what's going on? Because I'm
no.
really...
So do you feel
like
her going out with her friends and seeing a therapist is a negative thing? Like, it sounds like you have some concerns that people are feeding her ideas that may not be accurate and giving her a different perception.
I think coming to a therapist, I know I sound like a broken record. I mentioned, like, okay, she's going through treatment, and that the doctor suggested that for her to come to see you. And I think it was good, because she was, after treatment, she would just stay home. I tried to entertain her, or kind of get her out of her, you could say, like, maybe she was feeling sad. And I was trying to kind of motivate her, but it was like nothing I was doing. Like, I was there, but then I was also, like I said, in the computer working on sales, and so I was there, but at the time, so I wasn't, maybe. And so now that she's going, the doctor has said that she needed to come for therapy, okay, I think it was good for her to kind of express herself, things that she was, whatever she's feeling.
So would you guys say that prior to the diagnosis and prior to treatment, your relationship was better?
I think so.
Okay. So I'm seeing your diagnosis and your treatment as one of the major factors in a change of your relationship. Would you guys agree with that?
Not for me, yes. I don't know.
I'm sure you'll say
the same.
Okay. So what do you guys think? What's changed? I mean, obviously, you had a life-threatening experience.
What's changed? I think it's her. Just her overall.
Okay.
Seeing the world different, and just herself. I don't know. I don't think I have changed.
You have.
I don't.
Well, because before, we both used to work. Mm-hmm. We were financially stable. I mean, like how he said, we would go out and do things. When I started treatment, we didn't do as much as we can, and then because I got weaker with treatment, I stopped working.
Mm-hmm.
And so he was the only one that was providing for both of us, plus everything else that came with medical bills. And I understand that he was there for me throughout everything, and I am grateful for that. But I also feel like that also changed his attitude.
Okay, so, you know, when there's an extra stress in a relationship, a big change, it can obviously impact the dynamics. So, you guys are still together, you're still married, you said it's been 15 years. What's kept you guys going?
Because it's been so long.
I feel like it's been a good relationship. I know that she says it's been so long. Unfortunately, we weren't able to have kids, but we were able to use our time by travel and,
mm-hmm.
and go and do things together on the weekend. But it just
we don't do that.
And like what she said about that feel like it was a burden. I mean, I always told her that I wanted to be the like she worked because she wanted to. Not because, I mean, yeah, the extra money was helpful to do extra trips or take long vacations. I always took pride on being the provider, the sole provider of the home. And now I'm doing that. And I don't have but with her medical bills, like, more bills are piling up.
Yeah.
And yes, I feel a little bit of pressure, but there is not a, I feel like, there's no issue here. Like I said, I don't know her friends or whatever her friends are telling her.
My friends
are
not telling me.
She's going out more, and I like that because she was, like I said, she just used to stay home. She was a soul.
So you see some of her changes as kind of evidence that she's doing better physically.
Yes, and I like that because it's kind of like I'm hoping that we can get back to where we were before her treatment and kind of planning and going out and
okay.
But it's like even sometimes when I was like, hey, look, on the weekends let's go on a date, it seemed like, oh, you know, like she doesn't have the energy or she kinda like avoids things. Avoids me to go out, like, oh no, I'm okay, I don't wanna do it.
Well, because I know like
but then her friends call like, hey, let's go for breakfast, and she doesn't say no to them.
So what are your thoughts on that?
I feel like because we're not financially stable, like we shouldn't be going out.
But it's just a simple move.
And like if
my
friends do ask me to come out, like they know where we're at, and so they ask, you don't have to pay for anything. We just want you to come out with us. So.
Okay. So I hear it coming back to some financial. But I heard you say earlier that you guys have been together just because it's been so long. So I want to go back to that.
Think for me it's like thinking about it, now that I'm thinking about it for these past few weeks, I think that's my thing that keeps it together, where it's like we've been together for so long.
So you've invested so much energy, like why stop now?
Yes.
Okay, so if you invested so much energy and you don't wanna just give up on that, what are some things that you guys both want out of your relationship that can keep you guys going?
I just don't want him to say like rude comments, like, oh, you don't do this, or like because of money, like, oh, now I have to pay for this bill that's supposed to be yours.
Okay. What are your thoughts on that, Miguel? Do you think that you say stuff like that?
Yes. Well, I don't say I'm like, I don't intend it to. Sometimes when we talk, sometimes it seems like for some reason it like our financial problems come up and I don't mean it, then accidentally I say things like that. They come out. Like, I don't mean it, I guess I'm feeling pressure, and I just like bring up the, oh, well, you know, like now, I know you want to do this, but I have this extra bill now. Or
okay.
Why is this bill coming? I thought that our insurance was covering and stuff like that. So yeah, she probably, she hears that, but I don't mean it.
So
I'm still thinking about, like,
yeah.
She says about, like, she thinks or she's just doing it because if it's, it's been a, like a habit, I don't see her like that. So I still love her, and I've been in love with her since, like, the beginning, but I don't know, that's kind of like, I'm surprised. It really gives me, I have mixed feelings.
Okay. Well, I guess, I mean, it sounds like this is coming as a surprise to you.
Yeah.
Which indicates to me that you guys may not be communicating on a level that's effective to meeting each other's needs. So.
Yeah, like at home, we thought we were doing well, like talking, and I guess we're not. She, a lot of times she doesn't really want to talk. Like I would ask her, what's wrong with you, or what's going on? You know, like, and she just like, oh no, I'm fine. And then I'll ask her about, like, sometimes about her treatment, and I notice that sometimes, like, bringing up, like, even mentioning treatment, she gets sad, and I don't want her to, like, to get emotional, so I don't want to ask her. So yeah, a lot of times we go, like, throughout the day, since I'm at home a lot, like, there's a lot of times that we go, like, hours without even saying a word. I'm in the room or in the office, she's in the living room watching the show or outside, you know, like she's...
So now one thing that I heard earlier is that you guys can't do the things that you used to do because of financial stuff.
Mm-hmm.
So you feel like there's some point you're not connecting because you can't do things that you'd like to do. Can you guys think of some kind of activity that you can do that wouldn't be a financial hardship but would still allow you guys to... connect positively to be
well,
able to
talk. I mean, I don't know, like, I'm a morning person, and we used to go on walks in the morning,
okay.
Like, to the park, for instance, to Hart Park, and but now it's like, even those walks, it seemed like she doesn't really care, or she, I don't know if before she was just doing it because to please me, and now it's just like, we used to go bike riding, and now she doesn't even...
So there were some things that you guys were doing that wouldn't be a financial hardship.
Yeah, like I feel like we can pick that up, but I don't see her interest or...
We never asked.
Or just like her, I don't know, just her demeanor. Like I don't see her, yes, I don't ask because I don't want to be like hear no, and when I hear no, it's like that kind of, because I kind of come with a positive attitude,
mm-hmm.
like a hype, like, hey, we should do this, like in my mind. And then seeing her, and it's like, oh, okay, she's going through it again, kind of like in my head.
What are your thoughts on that?
I would love to.
Mm-hmm.
I think when he does ask, it's at random times.
Mm-hmm.
So he'll just randomly ask me, but at that time I'm already upset because of like comments that he said. And so I just don't want to.
Okay.
But if he is able to